Did you know that Colorado is one of the 10 fastest growing states in the U.S.? As the population grows, so do our water needs. Colorado's water has many competing uses, including agricultural, industrial, recreational, environmental and ecosystem health, and municipal. Looking forward, our growing population, the many types of demands on our water supplies, and our highly variable weather mean we may have to make choices about the way we use our water and recommit to manage it better and smarter than ever before. As we grow, our water needs will exceed existing supply, creating a gap. State-sponsored research shows that the demand for water will exceed the supply before the year 2050. What's more, the basin's population is expected to grow by 2.5 million people, meaning that municipal and industrial water demand could double what it is today. So, what's happening? There are 8 major watersheds in the state. We call them basins. In 2005, the Colorado legislature passed a law that created basin roundtables, which are groups of representatives who collaborate and discuss each basin's water issues and encourage locally driven solutions to water supply challenges. Building off the work of the basin roundtables and with the new challenges facing Colorado, an executive order was issued in May 2013 calling for Colorado's water plan to address the gap and integrate a productive economy that supports vibrant and sustainable cities, viable and productive agriculture, and a robust skiing, recreation, and tourism industry. Efficient and effective water infrastructure promoting smart land use, and a strong environment that includes healthy watersheds, rivers and streams, and wildlife. Since that time, the Basin Roundtables have been developing basin implementation plans to guide the development of Colorado's water plan. A good Colorado plan needs a good South Platte plan. The basin is a key economic driver in the state. 7 of the top 10 agricultural producing counties in Colorado are in the South Platte Basin. Additionally, it is home to the Denver metropolitan area and other growing communities like Loveland, Greeley, and Fort Collins, which together account for over half of the state's economic activity. The basin's economy is also enhanced by environmental and recreational tourism, including skiing, boating, fishing, wildlife viewing, and hunting. The basin is also home to the state's most visited state parks and the eastern half of Rocky Mountain National Park. To meet existing water needs, South Platte Basin water managers rely on an extensive network of facilities and a vast system of privately owned water rights. Long-standing efforts to conserve and reuse water in order to get the most benefit from available supplies has meant that by the time water flows out of our state, each drop has been used multiple times for different purposes. As the South Platte Basin's population and economy grow, we are approaching a threshold where we'll have to make trade-offs in how our water is used, and our ingenuity and inventiveness will be needed more than ever before. If we don't plan carefully, the important environmental, recreational, and agricultural water uses that characterize the basin may begin to disappear. Most striking, up to 50% of today's irrigated cropland in the basin could be dry before 2050. We need a plan that not only maintains healthy economies and communities, but finds ways to enhance environmental and recreational resources in many places. In short, we need to keep doing what we're already doing, but do it better while working to make our rivers and streams healthy. Trying to juggle our many needs for water can be hard. That's why we are developing the South Platte Basin Implementation Plan. We are identifying solutions to meet our many needs. Are there more ways to conserve and reuse our water? Can multi-purpose water projects get built? Are there additional water supplies from outside the basin? When water is transferred to cities and industry, are there ways to minimize the effects on agricultural production and rural economies and maintain a farmer's property rights? Are there ways to maintain and enhance our environment and recreational resources while meeting all our competing water needs? Evaluation of new and expanded infrastructure and storage will be important for implementing all strategies. The draft plan considers a wide range of strategies that could be used in various combinations to meet the gap. Conservation and reuse, multi-purpose water projects that include municipal, industrial, recreational, and environmental components, agricultural transfers including alternative transfer methods, Colorado River Basin supplies, and storage. Throughout, we must work to maintain and improve our environmental and recreational resources that make the South Platte Basin a great place to live. So we need your input. Read the plan and learn how we can meet our water needs. Then, help us by offering your input. How should we meet our growing water demands? What's most important to you? To learn more and provide input, check out southplattebasin.com. To take our survey, click here. And to see what other parts of the state are doing, please visit coloradowaterplan.com.